The other day, someone asked me a question about like what standard should leaders be held to, and I thought of this answer, and I think this is true as well. I think for the youth generation today, I think we actually, as believers, whether or not we're platform or not, as believers, we're called to a higher standard. And there are many passages in the Bible that said for us believers that He's got big plans for us, and He knows the plans of our future, plans to prosper us, and all that stuff. And if there's anything I've learned along my journey, I do believe that to be true, but I also don't believe that everything is going to be sunshine and roses. I don't think being a believer promises that. But what I do believe is that God maybe sometimes allows us to go through trials to stretch us and to grow us, to make us more of who we're meant to be. And so my advice to any of the youth of this generation would be that trust in God and continue to lean on Him, and there are going to be difficult seasons. And added to that, to the youth of this generation, especially to the leaders, I would say I'm grateful today that I had leadership that was okay, that didn't judge me and didn't rule me out when I made mistakes, when I messed up. Because ultimately, for me now, a little further on, I would rather have young people to lead that are open and honest and let their shortcomings come into the light, and people who are willing to go on the journey and grow and allow themselves to be stretched, and lead people who look great, but on the inside are hiding. So let's be people who are honest and want to grow and trust in God through every season, that He is ultimately going to have our best.
Amen.
Youth in general, that season of your life is, and if the fact that it's constant change, high school, adolescence, deciding what your career is going to be, your friendship groups. And my practical advice from doing that season would be to find the consistent things and your convictions on what is not going to change. And I think the things that should change and should stay consistent would be reading your word, getting in the Bible, and getting the promises for yourself. It's great to, hear amazing messages on the platform, but if you don't take that into your Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, it doesn't sit deep and help you every day. I would be really intentional about your friendships and the voices that you're listening to. I would get people who have been on the journey and are ahead of you, alongside you, to encourage you and to spur you on. I would be plugged into a church. I would make sure that you're living, beyond yourself, and that you're, that you're walking out your calling in serving the church and building the church. And I think, you can't go wrong.
I'll keep mine short. I'll say, be real, like be legit, like on the outside and on the inside. And I think so many people can sense when someone isn't, like when those two things don't match up. And that's my short thing.
That's great. I've been reading a lot of 1st and 2nd Thessalonians lately. There's a lot in there about living a righteous life, and it's interesting how even Jesus said, be holy as I am holy. Mm-hmm. Or in some translations, be whole as I am whole. And I definitely think that we reflect that what we surround our time, or surround ourselves with, in our time with. And so, getting to God's presence, you're going to reflect the Holy Spirit. And, watching more Netflix than you are reading your Bible, you're probably going to start reflecting Hollywood. It's up to you.
Yeah.
Cool. We're going to do we'll jump over here. Yeah, we got a few more minutes left, so just... Awesome. All right.
So am I. I'm very excited.
I'm wearing your shirt. I bought it even in the last size.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
You can cut it and make it.
How are you?
I'm Aiden. Nice to meet you, Simone.